The Huawei Mate 40 Pro feels great in the hand, with its glass back and glass screen sandwiching an aluminum frame. The dimensions are 162.9 × 75.5 × 9.1 mm and it weighs 212 grams. And while those measurements make it seem pretty big for a phone of its screen size, the Mate 40 Pro doesn't feel overly huge. The curved edge display, which helps the phone fit snugly in your palm, adds to this impression. We found the power button and volume rocker right edge of the phone. Easy to reach, people with smaller hands might find it a little trickier to hit the higher up rocker, but most will be able to reach the power button easily enough. The Mate 30 Pro didn't actually have a volume rocker. As on that phone, Huawei debuted tech that allowed you to slide your finger up and down the curved screen edge to change the volume, given that the rocker has returned here. We'd guess the particular novelty didn't catch on. There's no 3.5 mm headphone jack here, so fans of wired audio will have to use a converter with the USB-C port in order to use their existing wired headphones, or look for USB-C wired headphones. Although there are few options around at the moment, the back of the phone feels sleek, but you might find that its appearance detracts from the overall impression of elegance, as our review unit quickly became a canvas of fingerprint marks. This was on the black version of the phone, and it's also available in silver, which might not show off finger smudges as much. At launch, green, yellow and white versions of the Mate 40 Pro were also unveiled, and we'd say these look a lot more striking than the black model. The Huawei Mate 40 Pro display looks pretty great, though the paucity of streaming service apps means that opportunities for annoying it are somewhat limited. This screen is 6.76 inches diagonally, which is pretty big, but as we've mentioned, the design goes some way in mitigating any issues with this. It has a 2772 by 1344 resolution, which is higher than that of many other phones. Most stick with 1080p, and as a result, images look sharp. The OLED HDR10 tech makes colors pop. Huawei claims that the display shows off 16.7 million colors, although we didn't stop to count. The high max brightness helps with this too. Fast screen refresh rates are the latest battleground in the smartphone spec wars, but the Huawei Mate 40 Pro caps out at 90 Hz, which some might find a little low for a premium smartphone. Others hit 120 Hz or 144 Hz. You can dial this down to 60 Hz if you like, which saves battery, but we went with the dynamic mode option, which automatically switch between the two depending on what you're doing. If we have one issue with the Mate 40 Pro display, it's the pill-shaped cutout that houses the two front-facing cameras at the top left of the screen. It's not exactly small, with quite some distance between the two lenses, so it cuts a fair amount. The Mate 40 Pro is one of the best camera phones out there, while its snaps are roughly on par with its top-tier competition. And which is the best phone largely comes down to personal preference. The sheer number of modes and options on offer here outstrips most of the competition. The main snapper is the same 50 MP f/1.9 camera we also saw on the Huawei P40 series and Mate 40. This has a RYYB sensor, red, yellow, blue, as opposed to the standard RGB, red, green, blue, which allows it to take in more light. This is joined by a 20 MP f/1.8 ultra-wide camera and a 12 MP f/3.4 periscope telephoto for 5x optical zoom snapper. On paper, that might make the phone look a little worse off than the P40 Pro, which had the same main and telephoto snapper but a higher res ultra-wide camera. However, that ultra-wide camera is where many of the improvements actually come, as it has an improved focal length, along with another key change that we'll get into later in this section. Pictures taken on the Huawei Mate 40 Pro looked fantastic, from scenic vistas and close-up subjects, or portrait shots.